We look at our problems. We start getting upset. Just like Israel, Moses brought us out here to die. God told Moses, stretch out your rod. Moses, what you doing? What you doing, Moses? We need a boat, not a stick. We need an army, not wood. What you need is God and faith in God. I don't care if you don't have an army. I don't care if you don't have a boat. If you got God, you got the victory. Remember the last time when you cried out and God answered your prayer? This problem ain't too big for God. Remember the last time when you're looking at something that the devil said is going to destroy you. Remember. Somebody said the last time. Why God, he opened up. See, they looked at the variables that they thought they would need for that situation. The divine order, the normal way to get across a body of water is a boat. We don't have a boat, so we don't have a solution. We got an army behind us, and we don't have an army to beat this army, so we don't have a solution. But they had God, the same God that changed that water to blood in Egypt, that same God that took the life of the firstborn in Egypt. That same God was right there with them at the coast of the Red Sea. All you gotta do is remember the last time. Stop looking at the situation and accepting defeat. You got God. Somebody say, I got God. I don't know how it's gonna work, but I got God. Start blowing on it. I can imagine some of them still getting to look out for me, because the enemy was still behind me, even though they were held at bay by a pillar of fire. But ain't God good? He know how to close the deal. God know how to do everything completely. I'm not only going to get you across, but I'm going to take in your enemy too. You didn't have to worry about them anymore. I'm about to give you another memory. That's what God wants somebody to know today. You're about to get another memory. Something else to think about. But you need to stop praying for what we've already done. You need to stop ending them up for what we've already done for you. The door that has already been opened. The way that has already been made. Yes. Oh, yes. Oh, God. He just was came up behind me. See, the enemy can't get your blessing. That blessing to get across on dry ground belongs to God's people. Have the enemy trying to come behind them and get what God had given them. God didn't give it to them. He gave it to his people. Then he took that same water that he opened up and he closed it up on the enemy. God knows how to close the deal. Some days you're going through and you're shaking in your boots. Lord, help me. You're scared of the devil. Lord, I don't know how to get out of this. You need to stop thinking back to the past. You need to go back down memory lane and think about how good God is. You need to punch up in your computer and recall that fire. How God healed your body the last time. You need to pull up that fire. How God delivered you the last time. You need to pull up that fire. How God restored your joy the last time. How he gave you back your peace the last time. How he forgave you all your sin the last time. You need to think about what God has done. Devil trying to give you amnesia. Trying to make you forget. Hallelujah. By God trying to give you spiritual dementia. Alzheimer's disease. Make you forget how good God is. But how do you know God is good to you? Somebody say, when I think about the goodness of Jesus, all that he's done for me, my soul cried out, hallelujah, I thank God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Remember. Remember.
Everybody's in the house. You need prayer this day. Amen. You might not have the Holy Ghost, but you're here. God doesn't want you to leave without the Holy Ghost. He did not tell on the cross so that you could go to hell. But he does know this. If you are not born again, your frequency will come to church. Won't save you. The Bible says you must be born again. If you're in the house today, you don't have the Holy Ghost yet. Today is your day. Somebody say, today is your day. Today is your day. If you don't have it yet, you can get it today. You don't have to leave the same way you came in. Hallelujah. The church stand at this time. If you don't have the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, and you want to make heaven your eternal home, hear the cry of the Lord. Come today. If you've not been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, the Bible says you must be born of water and the Spirit. You can be baptized today. God wants you to have it all. Amen. If you're sick in your body, God's a healer. How many in here has God ever healed from cancer? Let's see your hands. Cancer. I want you to look around at these hands. Raise up high, because this is a testimony to somebody that needs to see that God is a healer. How many, anybody in here that didn't have money to pay a bill? God opened the door. Amen. Look around, these are hands that God